Even though it hurts, I won't show it to you. Cause it will ricochet, I won't let it bite. I will look at you and tell you that I'm alright. Like a ricochet, it will come back to you.
Good morning. Official welcome to today's What I Eat in a Day. It is about 7:20 and I am going to make breakfast. I am hungry. I finished my protein coffee about a half of an hour ago, got ready for the day as you saw, and now I'm going to put together a nice clean ingredient, whole food, healthy protein packed breakfast. I am just 2 weeks out from plastic surgery. So these last 2 weeks, these first 2 weeks of May, I really want to focus on getting in healthy, real, whole food and really limiting the amount of processed foods that I'm eating. Hoping to lean down just a little bit more, maybe not weight on the scale wise, but just inflammation, bloating wise before surgery. So we're starting today off with a healthy whole food recipe. So let me show you what I'm going to have for breakfast. So I'm basically going to make a breakfast wrap. So I'm going to start with 1/2 of a lavash bread. These are huge. I never eat a whole one. I always just go with a half. What's great about these is it is 60 calories with 6 grams of protein and some fiber in half of one of these. And I like to put a little bit of butter on it and kind of crisp it up in a pan. So inside of my wrap, I'm going to do some egg whites. This will really help me get in protein, limit the amount of fat that I'm having so that I can save my fat for bacon, because I am going to put a couple slices of bacon in my little grilled wrap. We're gonna add some spinach for some greens, and then a slice of the Sargento ultra thin mild cheddar cheese. And then on the side, I'm just going to have some strawberries. I need to eat these up so I can cut up the rest of the pack that I bought and get them into a glass jar. I always tell you guys, put your fruit and vegetables in glass mason jars. They last a lot longer in the fridge. So let me make up my wrap and I'll be back to show you my breakfast. So here is my breakfast. I put it on my Uba home plate. You know, I love my Uba home plates. They have the dividing walls, which is great for portioning. You want the biggest portion to be your protein, smallest portion to be your carbs, and then the middle portion to be your vegetables. So it helps with portion control, and I love it just so my food doesn't touch. And the plates are just fantastic. I have 3 or 4 of them. They also have pre-portioned storage containers as well as bowls. I'll link Uba Home down below with 10% off. But I have my little breakfast wrap. I did add a teaspoon of Kerrygold butter to the pan so it would get nice and crispy and buttery on the outside. And then I have some strawberries. So I'll go ahead and put points, calories, macros here on the screen for you. So I just finished breakfast and I'm going to have my recovery supplement that I have every time I work out. So pretty much every day during the week. And you guys know that I take the Motivate Amino. Well, Motivate has not only repackaged, they've rebranded. So Motivate Amino is now Motivate Recovery. Isn't the new packaging amazing? They've actually repackaged a few things. I'll show those to you. But in addition to the rebranding, repackaging, they have a brand new flavor and I haven't tried it yet. So we're gonna try it first impression today. This is the new strawberry kiwi recovery. So this is the old Motivate Amino. It is now called Recovery. Now it smells so good. I smell sweet strawberry and kiwi, so I'm really excited for this. Like I said, I take this after my workouts. It has BCAAs in it. It helps with recovery, soreness, inflammation, joint recovery. It's just a great thing to have within an hour or so after you finish your workout. So I'm going to mix that up and we're gonna have that today. We're gonna mix it in my Motivate shaker. I love this. It's temperature controlled, keeps my water nice and cold. And then they also came out with another new product of strawberry kiwi. And I know a lot of you are going to be really excited about this. This is the Motivate Burn, but this is the no stim. So there is no caffeine in here. And this is strawberry kiwi as well. So I'm really excited about this. A lot of you are caffeine sensitive or you don't want to have multiple doses of caffeine through the day. So the no stim from the Burn that offers fat loss, metabolism boosting, energy, focus. Most of the flavors are in the stim version. They only had one flavor in the no stim, which was lemonade, which is amazing. They still have that, but now they brought in the kiwi strawberry and I've already had this. It is so good. So good. I fluctuate between the stim and no stim depending on how much other caffeine I have during the day. So the days that I don't have a second coffee, I usually will use the stim. On the days that I have a second coffee, I use the no stim. I use the burn every day. I find that this really helps with energy, focus, boosts that metabolism, helps with that little bit of extra fat burning. Love, love, love the new flavor. And then they also repackaged a couple of their supplements, the detox and the burn capsules. So if you don't want to take the burn in powder form, you can take it in capsule form and you're going to get the same benefits out of the capsule. I love the new packaging. Absolutely love it. And then the detox is great to just detox your body, help with inflammation, help your body rid all of the things in your body that shouldn't be there. It helps with gut microbiome. Really great supplement as well. I actually take this daily. And then this I usually take when I travel because it's a little bit easier to take it in a capsule form than it is in a powder form. But again, I use both of them and I just love the repackaging of the new Motivate products. So what we're gonna do is mix up the new Recovery in Strawberry Kiwi. We're gonna try it out, see how good it is. All right, let's test it out. Oh my goodness, this is amazing. You know what it tastes like? Kiwi strawberry Snapple. That's what it tastes like. It is so good. Wow, I am impressed. This is my favorite flavor. I like the pineapple mango one as well, but this one, oh my goodness, this is so good. If you don't use a recovery supplement or you need a restock, pick up the kiwi strawberry. It's my favorite. This will forever be a go-to for me. I do have a 20% off discount for Motivate. I'll link it down below for you. Are you having a bad day? Your brother's having a bad day. Tell daddy. Yeah, tell him. Brother, tell daddy. Say it's a really rough day for a Frenchie. Your brother is crazy. So I just refilled my water for the day. So I finished my Motivate Recovery, which was, like I said, absolutely incredible. Filled up my water bottle for the day. And in my Facebook group, I have seen several posts recommending a weight scale. Now you guys know that my life doesn't revolve around the scale, but I like to have a good quality, accurate scale. One that when I go to the doctor, it lines up with the doctor's scale or pretty close. And those of you that weigh in at Weight Watchers meetings, we want a scale that's going to align pretty close to that so we know where we are throughout the week. So I recently, about 2 weeks ago, picked up a new scale from the brand FitTrack. What I love about this scale is there's an app associated with it that gives you so much valuable information. This is the FitTrack Dara Generation 2.0 scale. It measures, it tracks, and trends your body vitals over time with 17 health measurements at your fingertips. You simply step on the scale. It's going to not only give you your weight, but it's also going to give you a ton of health information. It's going to help you reach your fitness goals 8 times faster, understand the different body metrics that can be improved on, see progress being made beyond simply just the weight on the scale. And it is plus or minus about 3% as accurate as a medical DEXA body percentage scan. Now you guys know that I had a body scan back in November and this scale is within plus or minus 3% as effective as that. So you can get those same results at home. It's going to measure fat mass, muscle mass, body water, bone mass, visceral fat, and more. And what's even better about this scale is everything goes directly to the Hume app on your phone. Everything you need to know, as soon as you step on the scale and it registers your weight and all of the other 17 metrics, it all comes directly to your app. It is very easy to set up. You just download the Hume app from the app store, enter your personal information, connect your scale in one easy step, step on the scale, and voila, you have all of your weight and body measurements. Now, I will tell you that the information that the app registers is similar to the BMI chart. And you know how I feel about the BMI chart. It's not accurate. So keep that in mind. It's telling me that I'm still overweight and need to lose quite a bit of weight to be at a healthy weight on the BMI chart, which I don't go by. However, my weight is accurate. It's giving me lean muscle mass, visceral fat, fat percentages, and tips and tricks on things I can do to lower those numbers and get them into a little bit more of a healthy range. I really love how accurate it is and how you just step on the scale and the information pops up in your app. You can click on each piece of data and it expands and opens and gives you even more information. Just such a great tool to really know where you are in your health journey and make whatever necessary changes you need to make to reach your goals. So this is a brand new scale to FitTrack. I've been absolutely loving it. And in fact, I reached out and they gave me a 20% off discount code for you. Now this scale is on par with scales you can buy at stores like Walmart and Target. This one just has a gazillion more features, and the price point with the 20% off is outrageous. So I will link the FitTrack Dara 2.0 scale down below for you with that 20% off discount. But I've really, really been loving it, and it's been a big game changer in tracking not only my weight, but my health journey as well. So here is my morning snack. I went ahead and weighed it out in my Uba Home pre-portioned bowl that I mentioned. If you can see, there's actually measurements on here from a quarter cup all the way up to a cup. So what I did is 3/4 cup of the Good Culture low-fat cottage cheese. You guys know this is my favorite cottage cheese. That's going to give me a huge, huge pack of protein. And then I weighed out on my food scale 70 grams of pineapple. The Sprouts pre-cut up pineapple is so juicy and good. So I did 70 grams on top of my cottage cheese, and that's going to be this morning's snack. We're back in the car. We are in the car. It is about 10:45, and I have a couple of errands that I need to run. Mother's Day is right around the corner, and I want to pick up something for my mom, and I need to be able to mail it off to her and have her get it in time. And then, of course, I want to pick up a little something for my mother-in-law. So I think what I'm going to do is go to Ross, because it's in the same parking lot as Dutch Brothers, and I'm going to go to Dutch Brothers and get a coffee. I'm a little tired today. I don't know if it was just the crazy workout this morning at boot camp or what it was, but man, I'm feeling a little bit tired, and I've got a pretty busy day. I have a couple of coaching calls. I've been filming, editing. Troy and I are going to clean the house today. I already did a load of laundry. It's already been busy, so I need to pick me up. I also thought, since we're in the car, this is a good time to update you. I wanted to let you know that my plastic surgery, you guys, is in less than 2 weeks. It's kind of crazy to me. However, it's been a bit stressful the last couple days. I actually got an email on Friday at about 4 o'clock my time, saying from the coordinator. So when you have surgery out of the country in Mexico, you have a coordinator, somebody that basically sets up your whole surgery, gets it on the schedule, sends you all of the information. Well, they send you lots and lots of emails, like 4, 5, 6, 7 different emails, and I just can't keep up with them. So I save them all. I put them all in a folder and I glance through them, but I don't thoroughly read them because there's just so many. Well, she sent me an email on Friday and she said, oh, I just wanted to check in. Did you get your blood work done? And I'm like, excuse me, blood work what? Blood work who? I had no idea that I needed to have blood work done. So I messaged her back and I said, I'm really sorry, but I must have missed that in the slew of emails that I've received. What blood work needs to be done, and is it something that I can do when I get there, or is it something that has to be done in advance? So she messaged back and she's told me about the blood work that needs to be done. So basically they're gonna test my hemoglobin, see if I'm anemic, kind of my blood clotting, if I have a blood clotting disorder. So there was about 4 different types of blood tests that need to be done. And she said, yes, you can have them here when you get to Mexico. However, if there's an issue, we have to send you home and reschedule your surgery. So obviously I'm not interested in that. I don't want to get all the way down there and then have some fluky thing with my blood work happen where I can't have surgery. Now, the last time I had blood work, my iron was low. So I've been actually taking an iron supplement every day. So now I'm scared that my iron's going to be low and I'm not going to be able to have surgery. So it was a little bit stressful because it was too late in the day on Friday for me to figure out how I'm supposed to get blood work and get it back in time for me to go in 2 weeks. So what I ended up doing this morning was going on to the Sonora Quest, which is our blood center, which is in Green Valley, which again is like 10 minutes from me. It's where my husband goes to get his blood work done. And luckily I was able to schedule my blood work online without doctor's orders. So that was great. It was $80 for all the blood work that I needed. So I'm going in Wednesday morning at 9:50. To get the stinking blood work done, and it should only take a couple days to get it back. So I'm hoping by the end of the week I'll have it and can get it sent off for approval. That's the last piece of the puzzle that I have to do prior to going, other than having a COVID test when I get down there, which I think is interesting since technically the pandemic is over, but they want us to do a COVID test when we get there. Not an issue. So those are really the only things that I have to wrap up prior to going to surgery. So I'm just grateful, honestly, that I was able to get onto the website and get that blood work scheduled, and that it's only about $80. So super affordable. So that stress is over, and now it's just getting pre-filmed, ready to go for my surgery, getting all my work done. I'm booked back-to-back coaching calls till I leave. I'm almost booked up through May when I get back. So it's been a lot, but this is also why I need a second coffee today. So let's go to Dutch Brothers and then let's go see what we can find for Mother's Day at Ross. My life is about to be complete this morning. Cheers to Dutch Brothers. I get a lot of questions of what I get from there. I always get the exact same thing. So I'm going to let you guys know if you have a Dutch Brothers near you or if you ever go to one. My favorite thing is a medium iced Americano with two extra shots. So I always get two extra shots. And then I get the sugar-free white chocolate. So it's a sauce. So there are points and calories associated with it. So I'll put all that information here on the screen. I'm officially at Ross. It's literally in the same parking lot. So let's go shopping. It is so windy today, but it's 85. So nobody's complaining that it's 85, but it is so stinking windy. Of course, the first stop is the dog section, and my cart is already loaded up. So my mother-in-law loves outdoor things, so I wanted to check out this section for her. I'll do a little haul when I get in the car. House haul. Okay, so let me show you what I picked up. So starting with the dogs, I got these Lovin' Tenders duck filet. When I buy dog treats, I'm always looking at the ingredients. I don't want weird things in my dog treats, and this is literally just dried duck. And then I saw these Pet Life dog biscuits. They sell this brand at my vet. So I picked these up. They were only $1.99. This is a really good treat brand, the Wellness Soft Bites. These have nice clean ingredients. This is lamb and salmon. And then I bought these before too, the brand Baxter Boy. These are 100% chicken, so just chicken jerky. And then for my mom, since I have to ship it, I tried to be reasonable in what I was getting her. I got her pajamas last year, so I didn't want to do that again. So I did see this little sign that says enjoy the little things, and my mom has this type of decor in her house, so I thought that that was super cute. And then my mom entertains a lot. She has a million friends. She's in a sorority, and I saw this acacia and marble cutting board. You guys, this was $4.99. That is such a good deal, and it has a strip of marble down the middle in acacia wood. So I'm gonna send that to her. And then they do like girls night, sorority night, wine night. So I saw these towels that say wine and friends make a great blend. So I thought that I could include that in the little package. I am going to go to Trader Joe's tomorrow when Lola's at chemo, and they always have cute Mother's Day cards for like a dollar. So I'll grab my mom and my mother-in-law a card there, and then I'll package that up and get it sent off. And then for my mother-in-law, she loves chocolate. So I saw this little Mousse Munch premium popcorn with chocolate. So I always like to get her a little sweet treat as part of her gift. Bag number two, this has more of the breakable types of things in there, but I did grab little Mr. Palmer Clayton a couple of toys. I always tell you guys I can't get anything really with stuffing. This does have stuffing in the face, but it has kind of the scrunchy body, and this one was only $3.99. And then I found this one too. I thought this was really cute. It has 16 squeakers, so he'll have a good time ripping all of those out. $4.99. And then my mother-in-law loves like outdoor decor, and she loves blue. Blue's her favorite color, like a teal. So I found this wind chime. It has this really pretty upside down kind of fluted vase, a nice rope handle. It's a little tangled right now, but then it has this really pretty kind of medallion that matches hanging from the bottom. This was only $12.99. I thought that was a really good deal, so I picked that up for her. And then also for her, I just couldn't pass it up. My mother-in-law entertains a lot too. They're part of pickleball groups, bowling groups, golf groups. They have lots of friends over all the time. So I saw this really pretty platter, and it has flowers and kind of a raised butterfly. Clearance for $4.99. And then they had one that had strawberries on it too, but I felt like this just kind of screamed my mother-in-law more, and it's a nice ceramic serving platter. So I've got gift bags at home, and like I said, I'm going to look for a card at Trader Joe's. So I am pretty excited about those finds at Ross. My total was $68, so not bad at all. Troy texted when I was in Ross and asked me if I could get him a pop, so I'm going to stop and do that. Also, I'm down to a quarter tank of gas, and Lola has chemo tomorrow,
So I am also going to grab some gas. So those will be my last two stops before heading home. I'm really, really hoping that I can get some lunch in before my first coaching call today.
Like I mentioned in my weigh-in video on Friday, I have been so sore. Taking a week and a half off of boot camp literally almost killed me. My inner thighs and my butt were sore up until really yesterday, and I'm afraid that I'm gonna be just as sore again after today's workout. We did burpees, we did squats, we did push-ups, sit-ups, we did all the things. So I am actually going to take a minute to myself, a little relaxation, and give myself an at-home massage. Now, when I went to New Orleans, I went to the Ritz-Carlton for a spa day, had a luxurious massage, and decided that I needed something at home to give me kind of that full body massage. My neck, my back, my hips, everything after a really hard workout. Not to mention, you know, Troy has quite a few medical issues that leads to a lot of soreness and inflammation. So we decided that we were going to pick up an at-home massage mat. So I did a ton of research. I wanted something that was affordable and that was effective and easy to store, because I don't have room to store a big massage bed or a big massage mat. So I found the Lapuler massage mat. It actually has massaging features, twist and stretch, and 7 different massage modes. It gives you that full body massage for back relief, pain, inflammation, soreness. It has an adjustable vibrating massager that you can put on your bed, your sofa, your floor, anywhere you want to take a good massage. I decided to go ahead and just sprawl out on my office floor. It combines compression and vibration that helps eliminate fatigue. There's 4 different massage zones: neck, upper back, waist, and hips. There's also 3 intensities to relieve your stress and muscle pain. The massage cushion has 7 different pressure modes. It's kind of like doing yoga, easily, gently massaging your neck. It pushes up on your back and waist with airbag traction. I like the twist and stretch and energize and flow options as well. This is going to massage your neck, back, and lumbar by traction. It really helps with the lumbar by adding pressure in the right places to relieve body pain, fatigue, and relax your tense muscles. It has an adjustable height for your neck and your booty, so you can kind of place those where you need to place those on the massage mat. Everything is operated with a remote control, which is very lovely. As you're laying on the massage mat, whether that's on your couch, on your floor, on your bed, everything is done with the remote so that you don't have to get up. You just get to adjust and choose the settings that you're looking for. I also love its foldable design, so it just folds right up, zips up, has a handle, small for storage. That was one of the main things that I was looking for. It offers upper and lower back massage, neck massage, hip massage. It's pretty incredible, not gonna lie. We've absolutely been loving it. I've used it on my bed, on my sofa, on my floor in my office when I just need a little bit of relief. And like I said, I love how it folds up and is easy for storage. What's even better is you can pick this up right off of Amazon. That's where I bought mine. And there is a 50% discount code. So you actually get to save 50% off of the massage mat. And let me tell you that the mat costs less than 1 massage at your local spa. So if you're someone that loves a good back massage, neck massage, hip massage, all over body massage, and you want to save money and do it at home, I can't recommend the Lapuler massage mat more. We have been absolutely loving it. So I'll link it down below with that 50% off discount right off of Amazon. Lunchtime, I'm home from my little out and about to Ross and coffee, and I, as promised in my grocery haul, we're gonna test these out. These are from Mission. These are the Carb Balance Original Pitas. Now, I was going to make a sandwich out of these, but so many people commented on my grocery haul and said, make a pizza in your air fryer. So that's what we are going to do. So we're going to use one of the Carb Balance Pitas. These are 100 calories, so not bad at all. I do have some Sonoma Gourmet pizza sauce. I'm pretty sure this came from Imperfect Foods, and I'm really feeling like Hawaiian pizza. So I have some Canadian bacon from Sam's Club, that pineapple from Sprouts, and then I'm going to add some light mozzarella cheese, and we're gonna make a little personal size pizza in the air fryer. We'll be right back.
look at this little pizza. It looks incredible. I'm actually going to slice it with my little pizza cutter. I can't wait to dig into this. I'm excited to try these pitas out. Cheers. Perfect for pizza. I'm excited to play around with these pitas more, making sandwiches and maybe like breakfast pizzas out of it. Really good. Just finished cleaning the house and I'm gonna have an afternoon snack. It's about 3 o'clock. So I'm going to have one of the Organic Valley string cheese. You guys know these are my favorite. They are full fat, they are not light string cheese. I don't like light string cheese, so I'm gonna have one of those. And then I'm going to have 35 itty bitty mini pretzels. A serving is 50 and that's just too many. So I'm gonna go ahead and count out 35 and that's gonna be afternoon snack. So this is 35, so it's definitely a good amount, along with some protein in the cheese stick. For dinner tonight, I'm going to be making lemon basil chicken. We're gonna have that with sweet potatoes and green beans. So let me show you what's in the recipe. First, for sweet potatoes, I have these pre-made, ready-to-go ones from Sprouts, super easy and convenient. And then green beans, these are just some of the steam-in-the-bag green beans. These were in the fridge, we're gonna eat those up. And then for the chicken, you'll need 2 large chicken breasts, salt, pepper, minced garlic, lemon juice, honey, dried or fresh parsley, and then dried or fresh basil. So the first thing we're going to do is make the marinade for the chicken. So I added 8 tablespoons of lemon juice, and then I'm going to do 1.5 tablespoons of honey, about 3 cloves of minced garlic, salt and pepper, and then I roughly chopped up that pack of basil leaves. And then I'm going to stir all of that together. So I went ahead and sliced the chicken breasts in half long ways, added them to a Ziploc bag with the marinade, and then I'm just going to mush it around and get it marinating for a little bit before we get it on a sheet pan and cook it in the oven. So I'm going to go ahead and add the potatoes to a sheet pan. I'm going to throw them in the oven with the chicken. That way they will get warmed through. And then I have another sheet pan here ready for the marinated chicken. Spread those out on the baking sheet. And then everything is going into a 400 degree oven until the sweet potatoes are warmed through and the chicken is cooked. So I went ahead and warmed up the green beans, added a little bit of Kerrygold butter, salt, and pepper. We have our lemon basil chicken that looks amazing. And then I warmed through the sweet potatoes as well. So let me go ahead and plate this up and I'll be back to share points, calories, and macros. So here is my dinner. So I have one of the lemon basil chicken breasts. I have 120 grams of the roasted sweet potatoes and about a cup of the green beans. I really want to get some veggies in, so I went lighter on the potatoes, heavier on the green beans. All right, it's time for some dessert. I'm gonna do one of my favorite desserts. That is a serving of non-fat plain Greek yogurt, and then I mix in one of the Clean Simple Eats protein. Let me just tell you how amazing the strawberry cheesecake is in this dessert. It literally tastes like cheesecake, especially with the non-fat Greek yogurt. And then I'm going to top it with a tablespoon of graham cracker crumbs. That gives it some texture. And then just a tiny bit of some fat-free Ready Whip. And this is like a 35 gram of protein dessert, and it is so incredibly delicious.
That's a
wrap on today's What I Eat in a Day on WW. I hope you enjoyed coming along with me today, seeing all the good food that I ate. We tested out that new pizza recipe. So good. Tonight's dinner recipe will be on my website. I'll link everything I shared with you down below, including the massage mat, the new Motivate products, and the scale. Loving all of these things. So if you enjoyed today's video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not, because I do a What I Eat in a Day every Wednesday. And don't forget to check out the description box down below for everything I shared today, nutrition coaching, links and discounts to my favorite things. And of course, we'd love to have you come and join our Facebook group. Have a wonderful Wednesday, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.